In this radiology tutorial, we are going to learn how to recognize left atrial enlargement on chest radiographs. While assessment of cardiac chamber size and function is most practically assessed with echocardiography, the sheer number of chest x-rays performed means that it remains important to be able to confidently identify left atrial enlargement on radiography. As you can see, this patient has received a mitral valve replacement, but the effects of their prior mitral disease on the left atrium remain evident. We are going to compare with this normal chest x-ray. You will hopefully recall that the right heart border is formed by the right atrium, the inferior border by the right ventricle, and the left border primarily by the left ventricle. The left atrium is located posteriorly, and only the atrial appendage component is visible on a normal frontal projection. However, when the atrium becomes enlarged, its right aspect may become directly visible as an extra shadow paralleling the right heart border. This is known as the double density sign, or the double right heart border sign of left atrial enlargement. If we look at this normal CT for correlation, you can see the posterior location of the left atrium. Here is the left ventricle, the right ventricle, and the right atrium, where there is mixing of contrast arriving from the SVC with non-opacified blood from the IVC. The edge interface between the right atrium and the air within the right middle lobe is responsible for the normal heart border seen on frontal radiographs. As you can see, the left atrium does not project out into the lung, and therefore will not be visible on frontal radiography. If we switch to this patient, who has mild left atrial enlargement due to the presence of an atrial myxoma, we can see how the atrium begins to project laterally into the lung as it enlarges. This creates a discrete edge interface visible on frontal radiographs and explains the origin of the double density sign. If the double density sign is present, then the oblique left atrial measurement can be taken between the outer edge of the atrium to the midpoint of the left main bronchus. A distance of greater than 7 cm confirms left atrial enlargement. The main bronchi themselves can also be used to assess left atrial enlargement. As the left atrium dilates, it causes splaying or widening of the carina. An angle of greater than 90 degrees is considered a sign of left atrial enlargement. As you can see in our normal patient, the carinal angle is nowhere near 90 degrees. The final sign of left atrial enlargement we'll be discussing on the frontal radiograph is bulging of the left atrial appendage. Normally, the left atrial appendage contributes to a flat or slightly concave upper aspect of the left heart border. When enlarged, however, the left atrial appendage creates a discrete convex bump. For completeness, here is what left atrial enlargement looks like on a lateral radiograph. The left atrium forms the posterior heart border. Here is our normal case, and here is a case of gross left atrial enlargement, which bulges posteriorly. For further illustration, here again is our patient with left atrial enlargement due to a myxoma. So hopefully now you'll be able to confidently identify left atrial enlargement on chest radiographs by looking for the double density sign, an oblique measurement greater than 7 cm, a carinal angle greater than 90 degrees, and convexity of the left atrial appendage. You can read more and see additional cases on radiopedia.org. And don't forget to check out the other video tutorials in our chest x-ray series.